Hi, I'm Jim from affordablebindingequipment.com. I'm going to show you how to sharpen the blade from your plow that you bought. And this is the plow with the blade. These are the items that are in the bag that I sent you. You take the Allen wrench, you loosen the screw. Make sure you don't grab the blade with your fingers, but use some kind of a cloth or napkin or something to keep getting cut. There may be sharp edges still. Take the plow blade, take the screw, put it back through the hole. Take the rubber washer, the steel washer, and the nut, and screw that back on. And now you have a handle to hold onto the blade while you're sharpening. I'm going to go over some of the materials that are needed for sharpening your plow. Now this is the sandpaper. It's 220, wet or dry. That exact color. Here's the 500 grit. Here's the soap. Here's some water. And there's a plastic bag that the contents came of, and there's the contents sharpening that you need for sharpening. Keep your instructions out there. You're going to need some non-skid rubber cloth. They make this stuff that goes in your drawer, in the drawers in your kitchen to keep things from sliding around. Get a piece of that. Put that down. Now what I've done is I have a towel that's going to go over the top of this. So to keep the kind of mess in one place, if you have a really nice table, then you're going to want to put some plastic underneath here. And then this is a piece of glass that I mentioned in the instructions. This is 1/4-inch plate glass. Don't get anything less than that. When you get it, make sure that they sand the edges for you so you don't cut yourself. Take sharp corners off. You put that down on top of that. Now you have a surface that doesn't slide around. And then you're going to take the 220 paper, 220 sandpaper, and you're going to take some water and you're going to wet it. And then you're going to put that over onto the glass, and then you're going to take some water and put it on the surface of this. Then you're going to take one drop of soap and you're going to put that on there. And what the soap does is it keeps the grits from clogging up the sandpaper. You're going to take this by the handle and you're going to start sharpening. You go back and forth, circles. Back and forth, up and down, back, all over. Just go take up the whole piece of sandpaper. Now this will make some grits on the blade. And when you change from one sandpaper to the other, you need to wash the blade off in water. You need to take this off and wash this off for next time you want to use. And you're going to want to wash the glass off, so that you're not transmitting the larger grit into the smaller grit. This is how I sharpen the blades before I send them to you. So this is the exact same sharpening process that I use. Okay, you're going to do that about 100 times, and it takes about 5-8 minutes. And you're going to wash all these things off. I'm not going to do that for the video. I'm going to kind of rinse this off a little bit. Then you're going to take the 500 grit. Now I bought some sheets that were different. They're not full-size sheets. That's what I had. And you wet the back of that so it sticks to the glass, I hope. Then you wet the face of that. And you put some soap on it. Then you do the same thing with that. And you may have to hold it down with a corner or something. Be very careful. You don't cut yourself when you go into that corner. And after a while, it'll stick by itself, and then you do the same thing. You go back and forth, and you go circles and back and forth. Just use all of the sandpaper while you're doing this. Just like that. Okay, now you've used the 220 paper. And you'd use the 500 paper. You could go finer paper if you want. I haven't found it needed to go any finer than 500 grit. but you could go up to 1,000 grit if you wanted to. I just don't think it's going to make that much difference in the cutting blade. But now how do you tell whether it's sharp or not? And the only way I know in the trades to tell whether things are sharpened is you take your fingernail and you run it across the blade. And if it grabs and takes a bit of fingernail off, then you know it's sharp. If it just slides right off without grabbing, you don't have to put much pressure on it. You just kind of like that. There's probably another way to do this. This is the only way I know to do it. Don't do this, you cut yourself. But just take your fingernail and just run, slide right up. Now in instructions I say that if you like to paint your nails, then you're not going to want to do this, then find some guy like me who's willing to test it for you. But I don't know if you can see in the video, a little bit of shavings that are coming off there. But that's a sharp blade. And that's the sharpening of the blade. Now, set this aside. Now you really need to be careful when you're grabbing hold of this thing because it's now very, very sharp. So don't hold it without some kind of a rag or something in the way. Take this. Take the nut off. Take the steel washer off. Take the rubber washer off. Get your plow handle. Screw this back in. And use the Allen wrench to tighten it back up. Now make sure you have this tight. Not too tight, but tight, or the blade will spin around and it won't cut. And that's all it is to sharpening your blade to your plow.